The NBA season has officially been suspended after Rudy Gobert tested positive for the novel coronavirus. I think this decision was inevitably coming at some point or another, but after seeing this video of Rudy Gobert kind of joking about this and touching all the microphones at a press conference, it's just a really disappointing thing to be on top of what's probably been the craziest day in recent NBA history. Welcome back, everyone, to your number one source for learning about everything related to sports injuries and sports medicine news. In this video, we're going to talk about the recent news that the NBA is suspending the season indefinitely after Rudy Gobert tested positive for the novel coronavirus. Right off the bat, I 100% support the NBA's decision, just like I support what the NCAA is doing and other sports organizations and even non-sports organizations have done. I think the sheer numbers of this suggest that this was coming at some point or another. It just so happened to have been tonight. At some point or another, somebody within these professional sports organizations was going to be exposed to someone and test positive. This video of Rudy Gobert touching all the microphones and joking about how this isn't a serious thing certainly is really disappointing to see. But it's important to know that he was likely infected before this and would have been touching things in the locker room, would have been around teammates, and potentially exposing people even before this unfortunate situation, as bad as this looks. So what happens next now that one of the players in the NBA has tested positive? One of the most important things to stop a spread of a pandemic like this is to rapidly identify the individuals who are infected and then identify those people that they were in contact with and monitor them to make sure you don't continue to spread the infection out and around. So know this coronavirus has an incubation period, meaning Gobert was likely infected with this a number of days ago before he started to show symptoms. And so the monitoring of who might have been exposed has to go all the way back to the initial time point where the doctors would determine that they believe he was first exposed. Once they identify the individuals who were exposed, it's going to be about isolating them, monitoring their symptoms for a period of time, usually 1 to 2 weeks, to see if they develop signs of the infection, testing them, and then repeating that process with anybody who's infected to make sure you squash and sort of quarantine and isolate all those peoples who are sources of the infection. I don't foresee any way that the season could have continued on at this point based on Gobert testing positive. Just from the sheer number of people that he would have exposed and been in close contact with, you're not gonna have enough people to play a season. I want to address again that the attitude of saying that this is just the flu is not an appropriate response. This is not cause for panic. This is not cause for mass hysteria and anxiety. Like Dr. Mike has been saying this whole time, alert, not anxious. But this is more serious than the traditional flu. There's simply no arguing with that. Even if you are not in a population that might be more susceptible to having severe complications, you can spread it to somebody who is more susceptible to those complications. And so everybody is equally important in this whole process of trying to limit the spread of this infection. Having these joking attitudes and not taking things seriously, like we saw happen with Gobert, really compounds this problem and makes it hard for everybody to have the proper amount of diligence and oversight to avoid spreading this disease. I fully expect the NCAA is going to do something similar, and they're also probably not going to have a choice. All it's going to take is one member of a team in one of these locker rooms or organizations or schools to become infected, and then there's just not going to be the ability to continue playing the tournament. You know what? I support this. I think this is a necessary step. Sports will come back. Sports will be there in the future. But if we don't take these necessary steps to limit this community exposure and prevent mass groups of people from coming together who are infected or exposed, then it's just going to be longer and longer of a delay and have more wide of an impact. This novel coronavirus is here. There's no denying that it's going to continue to spread. There's going to be more and more cases. And this is undoubtedly going to touch and affect somebody that you know and in your community. This is what we've been trying to prepare for with all this education. Hard to hear that and then say, don't panic and don't be super anxious, but reacting that way doesn't help the situation. And so that's why people shouldn't react that way. Hope this action by the NBA helps people see the severity and the importance of this situation and makes them more diligent about what they're doing with washing their hands, being out in big groups, and exposing themselves and others to potentially being infected. Got to get rid of this, it's just a flu attitude, because that's going to cause people to become complacent. And it's going to make it harder to limit the spread of this now pandemic. The whole debate about shutting down schools, shutting down businesses is one that's honestly over my head and a lot more complicated to decide upon. Now that we've had somebody in the NBA test positive, we know about the risk of exposure and spread. The NBA has no choice, and I really hope the fans see this and give the NBA credit for taking a quick action in responding to this positive test and deciding to suspend their season indefinitely until we can really get this under control and keep the players safe, keep the fans safe, and keep even the non-fans safe as well. Highly recommend you all go check out the latest Joe Rogan Experience podcast with Mike Osterholm, talking about this pandemic and giving really good, easy to follow explanations, debunking some myths, lots of really great information. There's not some magic pill or drink or supplement or magnets or sitting in a sauna or whatever that's going to prevent you from getting this. You need to understand how important it is to practice your good hand hygiene, cover your mouth when you're sneezing in public, limit your exposure, and be more conscientious about what you're doing to potentially cause yourself and others to be exposed and spread this virus. I'm also going to link a YouTube playlist below in the description with a lot of other really good, really informative videos breaking down more specific information as this relates to kind of the world outside of sports. Thank you as always for watching, everybody. Again, please don't go out and panic and just generate this mass hysteria. Understand what you can do to protect yourself and protect others, but causing panic, spreading a lot of fear, isn't going to help the situation at all.